Julius mentioned that he said to you that he wants you to keep being aggressive and liked how you played in that fourth quarter. It's been a balance all year, though, for you, right, trying to figure out, run the offense, execute what the coach wants, and then find the spots for you to be aggressive as well. How do you think that's coming along?
It's coming along well, you know what I'm saying? We're not winning, so it's not as good as we want it to be, but everybody's finding their figuring out their identities, you know, as a team, individually as well. But some nights it's going to be my nights and some nights it's not. I just got to recognize it.
Where are you finding these, not the angles, but you've been able to get some threes off, but when guys aren't right on you, is it just is that something that's just there because of the quick release? And is it something you look for, or do you wait to see what the defense does?
Just really try to read the defense, you know. I feel like I can get the shot anytime, but I'm trying to read the defense and attack it at the same time.
How difficult was Lowry? Obviously a huge game and an efficient night, only 16 shots. What makes him difficult to track?
All five people have to be aware on defense, you know. He's coming off ball screens, high ball screens. They're big sets, good screens. We all got to be up and engaged, you know. He's coming off shooting it really well. So, all five guys got to be engaged.
After the Dallas game, Luke said that was sort of an atypical effort in the second half, and he felt like that was better tonight. But is this encouraging or discouraging how tonight's game went?
It's definitely encouraging, you know. As many steps forward as we can take is what we want to do, you know. We had a good fight. We had a chance at the end. That's all we can ask for.